So we are here together for satsang. Satsang means want to meet inner truth on nature. And inner journey is the way to meet your own nature. Mostly, our all energy always going outside. 24 hours. Looking out, listening out, talking out. So energy not moving inside. Therefore we not get our reality. We don't know our real nature, our realness. Our real face. For that, you need to go put your energy little inside. Every day, sometimes 1 hour, 2 hours, as much as you have time, look inside. And it's called meditation. And meditation, by meditation, you can get consciousness. Meditation is the fuel, food of the consciousness. Meditation means simply, now I don't want to put my energy anywhere outside. My all energy I want to put inside. No listening. No looking, no talking, all sensation is closed. Because our energy leaking through these sensations, through eyes, through ears, through nose, through mouth, and through sex centers. So these centers from our energy is going out. And from these centers, when your energy going out, this energy going in world, become world. World means become unconscious, become darkness. And when your energy not moving, going in this sensation, then your energy moving inside, where no going out. Then this energy become conscious start. So we are here. Satsang meaning how I can go, how I can know my truth, how I can know myself. And when you coming to yourself, as you come nearer, one hand you know, start yourself. And second hand, you getting joy. Because joy also for energy has to come to heart. Mostly energy living in mind. Always mind, thoughts. And when you looking start, first you look your mind, you look your thoughts. And then slowly takes time to this mind getting cool, getting down. And then when mind getting down, getting cool, getting weak, then your energy automatic become free from mind and going in heart. And heart is opening start. This all spiritual journey is how I can open my heart. Because through heart only you can feel the, when you in heart, you can feel love, you can enjoy, no matter what you do, no matter whatever you're doing. But when you're doing with heart, small work, small thing, no matter, you will enjoy. You're doing very big work, also enjoy. You're doing very small work, also enjoy. Because enjoy only coming from heart. So all spiritual journey is meaning how I can open my heart. And many meditation techniques has. Some techniques has like a sittings. Some technique has like a dancing. Some technique has like a exercise activities. To make how my energy come back to my heart. And as your heart is opening start, you will see, you get new eyes. Before you see through mind, same thing. And when you see through heart, it's different. Things are same, but you will see differently. Because your energy is different. This you know. In example, when you in your home, you have partner, wife, husband, girlfriend, boyfriend, or family. When you be with somebody with mind, very different. Just normal, even more some negative, more irritation, more tense, no joy. And when you in heart, same person, same house, same family, same things, and you changed. It means your energy change. So this all journey to change our transformation of energy. We born with negative energy. Everybody has negative energy. Everybody has anger, greed, violence. Everybody has, less or more. And this all your negative emotions, anger, greed, attachment, violence, has to transform. And transformation only when this is coming, emotions coming, you have to watch. Meditation teach you how to watch, how to look. And watching is very, look like watch, one word, very simple word, just watch. But this is big chemistry. Watching is the big chemistry. With watching, everything is changed, transformation. Your anger become love start. Your attachment become friendly start. Your greed become sharing, giving start. Violence become non-violence. Sex become brahmacharya, no sex, beyond sex. So every, all your negative emotions, negative energy is changed. And therefore, we came here, in this planet. You born. Sometime question coming in you, why we are here? For what? What the purpose? What the meaning? Why existence send me here? So I say two things. First thing, when existence send you here, give you body, give you birth, maybe you not remember, but he's saying, go, I made very beautiful planets, beautiful natures, trees, animals, person, people, and many natures, star, moon, ocean, mountains. Go and enjoy. So first thing, understand, you came here only for enjoy. And this you know. Everybody want enjoy. Everybody looking how I can be joyful. How I can get joy. And whole your life looking this. Where is joy? How to get joy? And whole life we are busy with it. We looking maybe, here is joy. After some time you find, no, not here. Then you go different way. There also after some time feels not really. So we try whole life here, there, so many things. So mistake is happening one way. Where is joy, there you we not see. We are not looking where is joy. Joy not outside. Joy in you. Inside. Very big joy. As you go deeper, as you go more inner, joy will be more coming. More stronger coming. And you will enjoy, start your joy. So we have much joy. Only looking right way, has to look right way. That is with you. You came with big joy. But looking outside, and slowly your energy going out. Sometime you feel joy coming from outside, sure. Sometimes you're looking something. Sometime you're listening something. Sometime you're meeting somebody. Sure, joy come. But it is temporary. Looks like its joy is coming from outside. But really not. Joy inside you have. That other thing, outer thing, become excuse to bring your joy. Take out your joy. And by itself, without any reason, you don't know how to be joyful. And this is meditation. With meditation, you will understand how I can be joyful without anything. Without anybody, without anything, without any excuse. And this which day you know, joy in me, you have everything. And then you will enjoy everywhere, every moment, wherever you go. Because you enjoy always. So, first thing, existence send us, go, enjoy the life. Fully enjoy. Take all where around, every moment take as much as joy you can take. Because in joy, mind is melting, mind is dissolved, ego is finishing joy. Whenever you enjoy, less ego. When you sad, more ego. With sadness, more you are more. Mind is more. Ego is more. In joy, you are open. Your space become bigger. Your light become big. And in light, ego, darkness will be finished. So therefore, so much need looking for joy. And here we came to enjoy. If joy not coming in your life, we came here to enjoy, but not happening, it means something, somehow, your way of living is not right. Something wrong going. Somewhere you looking wrong way. And who knows the joy? They say joy in you. First you will be full of joy, will be full of love. When you are full, joy and love, now you have something to give somebody. Now you have to give really something to give to world. Give to people, give to others, give to nature. So one thing understand, love is not thing like give me love. Love always sharing, giving. And sharing, because first you have to be full of love. Then you can share. First you have to make you full with love and joy. And then automatic love and joy will share. First you become full, 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 totally full. And then overflow start. When overflow, then automatic. Then right thing is happening. Then you really giving something. Why existence send you here? Its right purpose is happening. Your purpose is done. Goal is done. So as you will be joyful, then second thing will happen. Suddenly you start to know who are you? Yourself. So these two things together happen. If you very joyful, you coming to yourself. Or you come to yourself, joy will arrive. Joy is showering. Joy coming to you. You will be full of joy. So these two things happen. So therefore two things for existence send us. First thing, enjoy the life. Enjoy everything. And second thing, know yourself. Who are you? Who I am? And which day you know who are you? You know everything. Every question is solved, existential question. All things you know. You know about your birth, about death, what you been before, what will happen after die, where you go. All secret is open. This is knowledge. And knowledge is showering on you. So, this is inner journey to make you like this. And which day you know yourself, you are totally satisfied. Now your purpose is done. Why you came in this earth? And till you don't know who you are, you will die. Again you have to come back. Again new birth. Then you not don't know, then again new birth. Always has to take, and we took many births also. Many times you came here. Till you don't know who you are, you have to come back. Because this is the goal. This is the purpose of human body. Why we take human body? Only human, man, can know who I am. Animal cannot know. These trees cannot know. Except man. Only man. Only human body can know. Only human body can be enlightened. Enlightenment means who knows who I am. Fully light inside. Enlightened. In light. When you in light, everything is right. And when you have light, your life will be perfect, right, where to go, what to do, what to eat, what to, how much talk, everything in order. Everything is clear. This you know. If you in night no have light, very difficult. If everywhere dark, you in your home, suddenly light is gone, power gone, very difficult. Where to go, where is door, where is window, you don't know. Light coming, everything clear. So meditation brings us to our center, to our consciousness. And as you coming to your center, light is coming from there. And you know how to live the life, what to do, where to go. Automatic, you have light and you know, you going. So this is the purpose to how. And meditation makes you, brings you from mind to center, mind to consciousness, from your periphery to center. When you in centered, perfect. Without center, chaos. Don't know what to do, where to go, how live the life. Much confusion. So, far should be right, should be center. So we are here, every day we have satsang. And after satsang we do one meditation also, one technique. In satsang I talk with you, sitting sometimes silent, sometimes talking. If you have any question, you can ask, I can answer as much as, and then it's like this, and then see, who knows, your light is open, your light is growing bigger. Light is coming, everything okay. Light is love. Light is life. Light is truth. Without light, everything chaos. Everything disturbance, confusion, tension, doubt. In mind, always doubt, always tense, always confused. If you want to do anything, mind say, no, do this. Then he say, no, no, do this. Then he say, you, no, no, do here. Many things he say. And you are confused where to go. What is right, what is not right. This is right way, or this is right way, or this is right way. This is mind. Mind is confused. So bad, right, come from mind to center. From center, everything perfect. And whole life, everything coming from center. Center is perfect, everything perfect. And periphery never perfect. Anybody's. Periphery always moving, shaking. Here good, there no good. Here you make good, there is finished. Always something up down is happening. In periphery. Periphery like you are now. Here in Goa. Every day you go, see the beach, ocean. Just sit near the ocean. And look the ocean. Ocean never quiet. waves are coming. You never can say, "Ah, today, now, ocean is very quiet." Something is there. Sometimes very much waves, sometimes less waves. Same like a mind. Sometimes very much mind, sometimes less mind. This is periphery. When you see the ocean, you see the periphery. So when you see inside in meditation, first thing you see your mind, periphery. Center you can't see it. Far center, you need to jump. You have to jump in ocean. When you go inside, go deeper, deeper, deeper inside, there are no moving, no shaking. Very deep down in ocean, totally, absolutely quiet. Nothing is happening. There you can enjoy. Same is our. From mind you come to heart, come to your center. Center is totally, perfectly, absolutely quiet. No any waves, no any words, no any thoughts. Nothing is happening there. Then you, when you come back, want to do, come back again in periphery. Do things, go back again in center. So meditation teaches how to I go by center, how to come back by in periphery. When you want to do, periphery need. You have to come back, come out. When no need, no work, nothing is happening, relax, go back. Then write. Then you will enjoy outside also and inside also. You enjoy this world also, or you enjoy yourself also. Both way you enjoy. So all spiritual things makes to you how you can enjoy others, outer and inner. How you can enjoy when you be with anybody, be with in outside, enjoy that. Enjoy with anybody, enjoy your work. Whatever you're doing, you enjoy. And when you're not doing anything, alone, relax, then totally go back. Go inside. Then you enjoy yourself. And meditation teach this. How can enjoy? So it's like this. This is journey of meditation. Meditation makes, do, love is growing. As you come back with you, love is coming up. As your energy not going more in mind, this all energy become love. Simply method. Stop the mind. Stop the thoughts. Thoughts stop, energy going in heart. Otherwise, all our energy mind is taking. Mind takes all energy. So no any energy for heart left. Just stop the mind. Just make quiet the mind. As our mind is quiet, this energy whatever going in mind, going start in heart. No need to open and to do anything to heart. Just stop the thoughts. But also, when you going to stop, very difficult. He is crazy. Mind is very crazy. One 500-600 years before in India, one woman become enlightened. Her name is Meera. She singing often. And she saying, when she look her mind, she say, "My mind is like a mad elephant. Mad elephant. If you see elephant, no, mad. Mad elephant can crush everything. Can finish everybody. Everything. When he become mad. Nobody can control him." So she said, "My mind is like this. Everybody's mind like this. When you really mind you are going crazy, nobody can control him. Only you can control. Only you can watch. Your awareness, your watching makes him cool down. So when mind coming, no problem. Let him, okay, as much as come. See how much mind coming. Just you watch. Look it. Let him to go out, out, out. How much he go? He has energy, big energy. Mind is very big, but is limit. He is limited. One day he will be finished. When his energy finish, then conscious energy start. Then consciousness energy start. Then mind is gone. Then awareness start. So as much as you watching, your this mind become awareness. Little, little part every day. Getting awareness. So it's like this.